tell us everything you know.
I'm not telling you a mother...
You can electrocute him all day. It'll only make him angrier.
I, on the other hand, will tell you everything.
Really?
Michael Bryce was trying to put his past behind him.
You need to forget bodyguarding.
Repeat after me. No bodyguarding.
No.
Then he got pulled back in.
Let go!
Jesus!
To protect this homicidal nutbag's wife.
What is he doing here? I said, get anyone but Michael Bryce.
I believe it's pronounced, thank you.
In 4 days, all of Europe will burn.
They're planning a full-scale cyber attack.
Do not screw this up.
But we are definitely gonna screw this up. I promised my therapist no bodyguarding. Let's not do that, guys. Let's just focus.
I got it. No, it's fine. You guys have at it. Maybe feather the brake a bit.
I need you to protect us.
We're trying to have a baby.
May God have mercy on our souls.
Rick Hong here for Hollywood First Look. Today, I'm with Patrick Hughes, and we are talking his movie, The Hitman's Wife's Bodyguard. So I wanted to tell you, man, I loved the first one. I was looking forward to this, and I laughed my butt off. So congratulations.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.
How was it slipping into it, like, from the first one to the second one? I mean, is it a little bit easier, or still like, man, this movie is just as challenging to do the series?
It never gets easier making these big movies. I think it's just this, anytime you're in the action genre, there's a lot of moving elements. But it was certainly fun. It was great fun to get back on set with all these characters, and having worked with them before on the first one, to have them, all three of them together in the second one, was something that was really exciting. And I thought audiences would love if we pulled Salma, who's, you know, like this crazy con woman that murders people at the flip of a dime, and you know, Ryan's this suffering fool, he's like a man-child, and Sam's this disgruntled sort of father figure to Ryan, and it sort of makes for this sort of wonderfully strange and crazy family.
I'll catch up with you later.
Who were you talking to?
That's a secret.
I know your secret. You are so lonely that you were talking to yourself. Ha! Listen, Breeze, do you really think I am crazy?
I think you're unusually aggressive, violent, but in an unpredictable way.
I would make a great mother, don't you think?
I think you're, yes. Oh my God, a child would be so lucky to have you as its host.
Thank you, Breeze. Thank you. It must be your powerful asexuality that makes you such a good listener.
You know, speaking of Salma, I gotta say, the delivery of her dialogue, her lines, her character was what just had me cracking up throughout the movie. So I was wondering, when you're shooting this, is she ruining takes for you because people can't, like, stop laughing on set?
I ruin the takes for myself. Like, we literally got to the point, we were shooting a scene with the three of them, and because I kept laughing so much, we were on stage. And it was winter, it was in London, and they'd moved me outside the studio doors so no one could hear me, and they closed the doors, and I was standing in the snow watching the monitor while the actors were inside in the warmth, having, you know, then I was allowed to laugh all I wanted because no one could hear me.
One of the things I really enjoyed about watching this was Samuel L. Jackson's maniacal laugh, and I'm wondering if his laugh offset is similar to that.
He's got a crazy laugh, and I love his laugh. And that was one thing in the first film, you know, when I first met with Sam, we spoke about it, which is like, he plays this notorious hitman, and he's sort of the opposite, whereas Ryan's sort of this neurotic bodyguard. He had this sort of swagger, and whereas he'll just laugh something off. So that was something that Sam is very, very good at, and he can switch it on, and he certainly has a wonderful laugh.
As you do sequels, you know, you got to make them bigger and badder, and you got to, like, add more, you know, cast, and you've got Antonio Banderas and Morgan Freeman. So how was it adding them to the movie?
That was a lot of fun. Morgan Freeman plays a really special role in the film. I don't want to give away any spoilers, but also I'd worked with Antonio Banderas before, and he's incredibly funny too. So it makes for an eclectic experience on set when you've got all these huge icons around.
So it's interesting for you as a director kind of reuniting, you know, Antonio and Salma together again, because they had great chemistry in Desperado.
They certainly did. They've worked together multiple times. So to me, it felt like, well, if there's anyone that's potentially going to woo Salma Hayek away from her husband, Darius Kincaid, then it would have to be Antonio Banderas. And they've got a wonderful chemistry. So it was easy to tap into that.
Yeah, I loved having him in there. I was just like, oh my gosh, I can't wait for like the two of them to have a scene together.
Totally.
And then finally, I mean, how happy are you knowing that audiences can see this in the theaters?
Well, that is the most exciting part for me personally, is that the cinemas have opened, because, you know, the world's been through a whole ton of challenges, and certainly to go back to the cinemas and, you know, for our film to be the first big action comedy, then, you know, like the one thing that you do miss from when the cinemas, when they were closed, is you miss that group experience and laughing and the sort of rolling laughter you hear when you're in a packed cinema. That's something that's really special. So I'm really excited to get our film out there, and I hope audiences can get themselves to the cinema.
The movie is The Hitman's Wife's Bodyguard. You can find it in theaters now. Until next time, I'm Rick Kong, and you've been watching Hollywood First Look.
Now repeat after me.
I'm unlicensed.
That's terrible.
Oh. Louder.
I'm unlicensed. And I don't give a...
We need guns. We need boats. We need them. Are you ready to get your freak on?
What?
That came out wrong. Not together. With us. That also came out wrong.
Now let's go do what we do and blow some things up.
Can we just acknowledge that not only are we safe,
this really feels like a newbie.